can I at least loot this place and then get the fuck out? Jesus! Okay, so they all came in at once. Hello, one and all. Horde night is over. We are relatively safe to go back outside. The ground floor is probably going to be swarming, and the damage they have no doubt done to the structure of the hotel is probably pretty severe. And yes, I felt so worried and tense last night that they'd actually get in here. I made myself a little escape hatch, like a little bitch. But that's fine. No problem. Don't worry about it. I've also made a couple more torches, and I'm starting to light this place up, as you can see. And I've also made my first good meal. Bacon and eggs. First meal, good meal that I can make myself. That gives you wellness. I know the main meal that I want to go with is meaty stew, but for that I need lots of corn and potatoes, of which I've still only got one or two of each. So we'll be going with bacon and eggs for now. That's where the meat that I'll be collecting is going to go into, with all the spare eggs that I've got. Today's mission, if I can make it outside, which I might just have to run as soon as I get down there. Or maybe I'll have a look and see what the zombies are like. Maybe there'll be corpses I can loot. Oh right, I also, when I was scouting out the edge of the city, I spotted two more watering holes, which doesn't make a great deal of difference. The distance to this watering hole is probably going to be the same as this one, considering I'm going to loop around the outside if I want to get water. So, not really a big difference there. Other than that, I'm going to need a bit more soil so I can, you know, get my farm a little bit more, you know, going. Oh, and I've also added all of the raw iron into here, so I've now got 500 iron. Not bad. But yeah, the goal is going to be get a little bit more soil, get a lot more fiber. I want to lay down the hay bales on the ground floor so I can actually do my easy drop down, I'm too lazy to walk mechanic, as well as setting up a ladder in this central area. And what's the last thing? Right, and the main objective of today is to go through the cracker books on the far side of the town, back where the apartment block was, where the feral zombie nearly killed me. Oh my god, I thought this was the ground floor. I was like, oh my god, why are the reinforced blocks gone? Or the frame blocks gone? Okay. That's still good, that's good. This hasn't sustained any damage yet. Oh, no, a little bit. How about the outside edge? Lots taken apart here. No. Ooh, wow, yeah, they are starting to draw away at that armor. Oh man, that's... I know it always sounds like more zombies than it actually is, but that sounds like a lot of zombies. How? Okay, they sense me. They do in fact sense me. Fuck it, let's just go. Trying to remember what all the noise the zombies make. Hey there guys, what the hell happened to you? Did you see that guy? He's just like, oh, I fell over. Oh no. So yeah, as you can see, it does look like some zombies are on a time limit. But as you can also... Oh, Jesus Christ, I didn't even fucking see that guy. As you can also see, no, the zombies don't automatically die at the end of Horde Night. So imagine if a couple feral zombies or a dog or two spawned and I had to get out. Look how many zombies are still alive. As the Horde Night gets tougher, the zombies that spawn will also be tougher. Meaning, no, you're not a dog. Meaning more the high likelihood of dogs and feral zombies. No, I thought there was a dog over there. Just a crawling zombie. Okay, so, oh my god, let's just get underway then. Chop up a few of these for the fiber. Pretty sure I need like 300 fiber. No, 350. I think fiber. And I've got 200. Each one gives me two. Wow. Okay, each one gives me two. So I've got a long way to go. I don't need fiber much beyond that point, but I do need some pretty much constantly, which is why it's almost always going to stay in my inventory. Oh, man. Yeah, you can just imagine how bad getting out of the hotel would be if there were dogs and feral zombies. Chicken over there, I'm not going to kill him. He's too close inland. And not to mention, I prefer not to get meat on my way out of the hotel. I prefer to get it on my way back, so I don't have to carry meat all the way through my journey through the city. Oh, man. So yeah, today the main thing I'm going to do is go to the Cracker Book. And I have to keep my eyes and ears peeled for those zombies that spawn that are running. Because I'm pretty sure it's due. They spawn like every other day. And it's possible that they spawned at night. I think it's possible. And I was just above them and they couldn't get to me. And they left. Or it's also possible that they spawned while I was running. Because it's happened quite often in my previous playthrough that I made it quite far. I was sprinting and sprinting from one town to another. And just by complete coincidence, I turned around and over this hill down into a valley, there was a horde of like 15 or more zombies. Which, I mean, that's pretty much how many you'd be facing during a horde night at any given time. 15 or more running, sprinting down the hill, down the valley, and then up again, and that's the location that I was. That's, I'm guessing, where I was, where I was when they spawned. So they were like, that's the direction we're going. And because I was running when they spawned, without realizing it, I must have got out of their hearing and vision radius. So they just kept running that direction, but it was the weirdest fucking sight to see a horde that big sprinting in the middle of the day. Oh, I could do with killing that deer. Sprinting in the middle of the day. As if it's, I don't know, fucking horde night. And, well, even more so, even weirder, or even stranger, that they're all ignoring you. Okay, 390. Let's get to, like, 500. 500 fiber, and I will be okay with that. I know I could be using my fists. You walk quite fast. You don't know. And I could be using my fists to do this, and... Okay, that was a deer. And it wouldn't cost me... the... What? Oh, just you. And it wouldn't cost me... durability on my tool. But then again, if I was using fists, then the skill points, the experience I'm getting right now, would be going into athletics. And not into construction tools. Oh man, why are you making it so easy for me to kill you? Come in, smack on the butt. That's right, run. That's right, run! So tempting. But no, do not. There's another one over there. God damn it. No, do not get meat on the way out. Get meat on the way back. Yeah, that's nearly 500. And that is a broken tool. I hear you. Oh, maybe you do walk quite fast. Don't make me kill you. A couple more. Oh my god, you bastards. Okay, that should be it. Come on. Yeah, 520, that's fine. Get rid of these plants. I know plants can be used to make teas, and they give a little bit of wellness, a tiny bit of wellness. I think like 0.1%, which is really fuck all, but it's something. And that way you could be drinking teas instead of water. Although I believe they give the same stamina, but obviously water doesn't give wellness. Oh, and right, yeah, I lost wellness last night. Or maybe the night before, I can't remember. Whoops, Mickey, put it on the screen. Mickey, back to work, edit, put it on the screen, which night was it? I lost a point of wellness because I wasn't paying attention to how hungry and thirsty I was. You don't see me. No, you don't see me. Because, yeah, I was standing by the fire, and I thought I had tons of hydration, but standing by the fire makes you warm. Being warm means that you burn through hydration a lot quicker. So let's check out this place. this one isn't boarded up, or doesn't have bars on the windows. I prefer to get as many recipes as I can early on to help me out. Not to mention higher skill points earlier on. The higher the skill points earlier on, the better. Remember, the settings I've got this game on is 25% less loot. And right now, it sure as fuck looks like that, because I've gotten so little. Wow. Well, somebody came through here. Nail gun, that might be handy. If I can actually find the parts for it, because I can't make them myself. Okay. Doing okay. You know what? Just fast forward. Unless something happens. Oh my god, that scared the crap out of me. Why are you making it so easy for me to kill you? That's not what I'm doing right now, dear. Would you even know how to get out of here? You're trying, but oh my god, you're so easy to kill right now, but I can't be running around with meat on me when I'm inside the city boundaries. Okay, so that looks like it's all the books. Let's find out what we got. Nail gum, exploding crossbow bolt, kind of expensive to make, probably won't make many of them. Leather leg armor, might make that. And I will scrap that. And hunting knife book. I can now make a hunting knife. In fact, I can make two. And if I already know the recipe, then instead of getting the recipe again, obviously you wouldn't get the recipe again, I will only get the skill points for it. So now I'll learn how to make a sawn-off shotgun. And with this one, I'll only get the skill points for knowing how to make it. What? Oh, hi. SMG. And crossbow. I know how to make that already. You're coming in, aren't you? Yeah, you are. That's fine. I might leave now. Is he? Yeah, he's coming through the door. Yeah, this is wood. I'll go through here. Maybe there's something in the back. While I'm here, let's check these counters. Maybe there is something. No, there's not. I will go through your fridge. Hey, another potato, that's good. Good for my farm. Need to be careful. Yep, there you are. Okay. Uh-huh. Yep. Come on. Don't know if I can be bothered to deal with you. You've got quite a lot of HP. Ah, screw it. You know what? Come here, you bastard. Come on. You have got the most amount of HP out of all the normal zombies. Oh, god damn it. And another one's coming in. At least another one knows that I'm here. Easy. Yeah, I think I might just go. I'd really like to know what's in the back room. Yeah, not books, that's for sure. I think maybe in that side room that's locked, there might be books. Oh, okay, didn't need to break that open. Sorry, buddy, I'm going to leave you in there. With a very bad headache, no doubt. After I gave you a pretty severe concussion. Okay, well, I've looted all the books in there at least. Or at least in the main kind of library area. But I haven't gone into the side rooms. Maybe I will, I don't know. Now let's check out this place. Shh, you see nothing. Stealth maneuvers. Wow, I'm already undetected. That's very nice. Undetected. And now I'm sensed. Could have something to do with the fact that I have my light out. But, I mean, even if not for you guys, I kind of need my light to see what I'm doing. It's pretty dark. Oh man, okay, you know what, fast forward, unless something happens. There are a lot of zombies outside. Or on the roof. What the hell? That sounds so close. Where the hell is it? Jesus Christ, that sounds close. He must be on the roof. He has to be on the roof. How the hell is he sounding so close? Fun Pimps, if you're watching, sort out your goddamn game engine. Because that sound is much, much closer than it fucking should be. There's somebody through the door now, I think. Somebody is at the door. Somebody's at the back door as well. Oh, no, right there. And now you're in. Can I at least loot this place and then get the fuck out? Jesus. Okay, so they all came in at once. Fucking hell, he scared the crap out of me. Okay, there's only two more shelves that I want to loot. And they are here, I believe. And that was it. Well. Okay, and we're out. Oh my god, I hate going into stores in the middle of the city. Oh, and there's a deer. Do I have any meat on me? No. Let's get away from here, just for a little bit. And I will go through the recipes that I have found. Let's have a look. Leather armor, rubbish. Exploding arrows, we already know that. Let's grab this. Eat that. Ooh, spiked club, that is so, so good. Okay, I'm only making one of them when I get home. That is very, very good. That's one of the best, or if not the best, melee weapon in the game. Hunting rifle, pretty decent. There's a zombie right in front of me. Crossbow. AK. That does not look anything like an AK. Not that I really know. And leather boots, which I'm pretty sure we've already got. But if nothing else, we've got another potato and we've got another piece of corn. So I should probably dig up some more soil to increase, to expand my farm. And maybe even if I'm heading back home, then yeah, just loop around here when I get to this corner. There are frozen zombies there on that corner though, aren't there? I don't know. Screw it, let's just go around. Yeah, guys, I don't know if I mentioned it. You guys probably saw in the fast forward that I do every time at the start of every episode. I reinforced the walls and the ceiling of my crappy little hut. Jesus. I turned it into wood. Yeah, I certainly wasn't feeling nervous, you know, the fact that it was Horde Night and everything, and that they could very well just charge through the front door and up the stairs, which they have done before. Though, don't get me wrong, I'm not going to hype it up. It's unlikely, it's very unlikely that they'd work out how to do that, but it has happened before. So yeah, I thought, I'm just going to reinforce all of this now that I've got the wood. Okay, so now that I'm kind of on my return trip, yeah, it's 4 o'clock. If I see any buildings, then maybe I'll go into them. But yeah, now that I'm on my return trip, I will keep my eyes peeled for deer. In fact, while I'm here, this is a watering hole, right? No, it's not. Well, that's a watering hole. There you go. That isn't a watering hole, really? No, it's not. It looks exactly how a watering hole should look. These lumps in the ground are where they should be, and the watering hole should be right in that middle bit. But no, it's not a watering hole. Well, let's get out of the city. Is that a... No, it's a tire. Thought it was a backpack. Okay, so Yeah, let's just loop our way around. I'll fill up those bottles of water, just because why not? Even though we've got a hell of a lot of water now, we have no water problems whatsoever. Because we've got so many bottles. And we have a cop. Yep, cop. And we've got a renewable source of water. Pig, though, we've got a pig. Actually, pig, I think I can just run you down. What's that, Shamways? No, that's a working stiffs. Okay, pig. Kill the pig. Don't run into the city. Don't run into the city. God. Okay, that cop's already lost sight of me. Okay, so that was a fair amount of meat. Let's get rid of the rotten meat and the bone. And let's keep moving on. So now I do need to be careful if I head in towards the city that the zombies will be able to smell me easier. Okay, so I'm already at the snow biome over here. At least I can see it. That's the watering hole there. And when I get around that corner, I need to dig up some ground. Wow, there's not a lot of useful buildings along this edge. Like, none. At all. Actually, no, there's a working stiffs right there. You can tell, because on the map, they have all the same layouts. So, if you have vision on the map, if you've had vision on the map, then you'll be able to see where there are shops. And if you remember what they look like by the colouring, you might even be able to work out what they are. So that orange one that I saw on the map there is a working stiffs. So if you see any other shops or any other blocks of city that have that shape, that have that orange strip on the front of them, then you know it's a working stiffs. My arrows are looking fine, aren't they? Yeah. I'm not using a lot of arrows. I probably still won't when I get level 600 bow, but at least the option will be there. In case I need to. Okay, let's fill up on water. Yeah, I hear you. Okay, that's all I need. Let's get out. There's a car park over there. There's nothing really interesting there. Unless I need mechanical parts, then I can go in there with a wrench and take apart all the cars. Or possibly, like, car parts themselves, like engines. And, well, I can't really think of anything else. Tires, maybe. That's a good place to find them. That wall is broken apart. That's weird. Let's have a look quickly in the snow biome, the little of it there is, and see if there are any hollow tree trunks I can loot, because they tend to have pretty good loot. Nothing so far. Oh, there's one. And there's another. Very good loot. And lastly, not bad for a random tree. Let's scrap that. And keep going. Okay, so yeah, I'm now on the south edge of the city. I can... Oh, yeah, there's a deer running through the city there. Mark my tower with the quick waypoints so I can see easier. And now if I see any animals, I will kill them for meat. Ah, I can't bother. You can stay there. Maybe when I get my spike club, then I'll come back for you. Actually, yeah, now that I've got the forge... Oh, hey there. And I've got the recipe for the spike club, I can skip the barbed club entirely, which is the in-between of the reinforced club and the spike club, which doesn't require a recipe. Sorry, a recipe. And I can go straight to a spiked club and deal so much more melee damage. Hello, I see you. Do you see me? Nope. Okay, get rid of the bone, get rid of the rotten meat. Okay. Yeah, you're fine. You're fine. You can stay there. Okay, we can get a few more eggs as well. Well, I've got a lot of them. Hey, zombie. I'll be going on a killing spree when I get a spiked club. Ooh, okay, so at this point, the hotel is right there. And I should start digging up some soil to expand my farm. because I don't want to be limited by soil once the corn and potatoes start to kick off. Because each harvest there will be double the amount, so I'm going to need double the room. I don't intend to use any corn or potatoes for meat stew until I've got, I don't know, at least 10 of each. So, shovel? And let's get to digging. Now, I believe it's required 10 dirt fragments to make one grass block. Just the way 7 Days to Die does its maths. Fast forward! Okay, so that is 120 soil, so it should be 10 more blocks for me to lay down. Which we'll do for now. So let's head back home, and with the rest of the daylight that I've got, yeah, let's be careful with my stamina. With the rest of the daylight that I've got, I think I'll dig out the blocks on the ground floor of the hotel so I can... Ooh, chicken, 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 chicken. Don't you run from me, chicken. Don't you run from me, chicken. Oh! You didn't die to one hit? There we go. No, you did. Do I hear a flaming zombie? Yeah, maybe. We're fine. And there we go. One more meat and lots more feathers. Wow! They just went to town on this, didn't they? Wow, that is pretty bad. As I said, I'm not going to reinforce any of the blocks that they take out. The oak, even if they're levitating, apparently. The only blocks that I'm going to reinforce is blocks I need to A, prevent them coming in, like those, and B, if I need them to lay down a ladder. And they knock out a block where I wanted a ladder to meet. I think when I start doing food runs properly, when I go out for the sole intention of getting meat, I will make myself a knife, because it is more efficient. Get the bones, get rid of raw meat. Not that I need plastic anytime soon. Is there anything else? Or anyone else? Look at the amount of holes they cut out of this building. You know what, let's just head upstairs and start digging out those ground floor blocks. Okay. Whew. What? Hold on, hold on. Fill that up. That's a feral zombie. I'm pretty sure that's a feral zombie. I don't recognise the noises they make well, because I rarely encounter them. You know, they're supposed to be rare. I'm pretty sure that is a feral zombie. And yeah, what I mean by this being... Actually, let's take a look at this. Sorry about being dark, guys. Let's grab all of these. Who are you? What? Hold on. Hold on. Fill that up. That's a feral zombie. Fucking hell. Scrap the shovel. Meat. Fast forward. I think this last block is fine. Thanks, game. I think I'll finish this tomorrow. You know, when it doesn't sound like there's a feral zombie right underneath me. I don't know for certain if that's a feral zombie, but that groaning, it sounds different enough that I'm worried it is. And past Mickey, you know, it's that time. Cut back to the previous time that I encountered a feral zombie and compare the sounds they make. Mickey, go! Uh, Okay, we are home. We're safe. Let's make some ground. Rossy ground. Do I have room for it? Yes, I do. Make as many as you can. 10. That's going to take 2. Yeah, do that later. Do it later. I was making hay there so that I can finish off the... Or because I can lay them down the ground floor. I know that I can just plant them on top, but I prefer not to do that. They don't have a great deal of health and they can be broken easily. And they take quite a bit of fibers to make. So, yeah, this is the end of day 8. Oh my god. I'm really worried about that feral zombie. I have to keep an eye on it tonight. Oh, sorry, tomorrow morning. Although then again, this is going to be the end of my recording session. I've recorded 3 days in a row. Or 3 game days in a row. So, yeah, guys, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let your friends know if they would enjoy this kind of thing. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Oh my god, if that is a fucking feral zombie. Shit.
No need to hide. I'll be over soon.
Oh shit, unless you're... Ooh, got the first shot off, but it wasn't a good shot. And there's definitely somebody else alive. Oh, yep, that's the legendary. Well, actually not legendary, more that's Ak-Ak.
Okay then. Let us begin.
Yeah, and that guy over there, I think he could do with a bit more blood being on the inside of him. Guys, this does look really cool.
Have you ever wanted anything so much that nothing would stop you trying to achieve it?
It's ironic you say that!
Something inside you, driving you forward. Instinct, I suppose. The will of your heart, pressing you on, though you know you may never attain it.